Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Connor, and today I'm going to be continuing my 2017 reading wrap-up with books 56 through 60. If you've missed any of the other parts of my 2017 wrap-up, I'll leave them linked down below in a playlist. You can check them out whenever you want to, but let's get started. The 56th thing that I read in 2017 is going to be All You Need Is Kill, and this is the bind-up version that has both volumes in it, but I just am counting it as one. The person that did the artwork in this is also the same that did the artwork in Death Note, so if you've read the two, you'll know that they have a similar art style. If you want to know what some of the artwork, it looks like this. And in All You Need Is Kill, Earth is being invaded by an alien species, and the main character, Keiji, I don't know how to pronounce that, is living in Japan, and he ends up in a time loop where he fights the same battle every day, and he dies in different ways every day, and it doesn't matter what he does and how he tries to escape getting killed, he ends up dying and then restarting and having to do it all over again. It's basically about the main character trying to figure out how to get out of this time loop and defeat the aliens. I've heard that this is a very underrated manga where people haven't really checked it out all that much, but it is very good. And I would have to agree with that I really did enjoy the story. I can definitely see why this was turned into an action movie. It's based off a novel, but I'm not going to read the novel. But the novel that this is based off of is what The Edge of Tomorrow is based off of, that movie with Tom Cruise. I've heard very mixed things about that. A lot of people don't like that, but they're based off the same thing. I ended up rating it a 4 stars out of 5 stars, the whole thing together. I really loved the action-packed nature of this manga, and I read it so quickly. I read the whole thing in one day, which it's not that short, and I also read novels at the same time as reading manga. It definitely kept my attention, but I think that they could have used more time with developing the relationships between all the different characters, the main character with the main female character, as well as all of the side characters, and why they would be so invested in each other so quickly. But I definitely had a really good time, and if you're looking for some action manga series and ones that are not a huge commitment, this is a good one. After that, I picked up A Gathering of Shadows by V.E. Schwab. This is the second book in the Shades of Magic series. I did a book review for it, which I'll leave up in the card symbol and link down below if you want to check it out. But this one continues the story of Kel and Lila, and they are two people that are both living in London. In this world, there are 4 different parallel Londons. It all begins when Kel is traveling between the different Londons because he's what's called Antari, and he's able to use magic to teleport, basically. And Lila decides that she's going to steal something from Kel, and then Kel tries to get it back, and then they get all mixed up. And then adventure ensues. I wasn't a big fan of this one. I ended up giving it 2.5, maybe 3 stars. One of the things that I like the least about this is that there is no backstory for Delilah at all. She's not got any type of history. And in this one, all the characters were pretty angsty and frustrating, but there were some redeeming qualities, like a new character named Alucard that was introduced, and so I'm hoping that the third book will be better and kind of save this series for me, but so far I am not the biggest fan. After that, I picked up The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin. This is the first book in the Broken Earth series trilogy, and the second book, The Obelisk Gate, was nominated for the BookTube SFF Award, so I had to read the first book in order to read the second book for that. This one I absolutely loved. I ended up giving it 4.75 stars. I loved almost everything about it. The world is absolutely fantastic. There's things called fifth seasons. It's almost like a future Earth, but not really. And anytime there is a period of apocalyptic events, they call it a fifth season. So a period where there's a ton of acid rain, or a period where there is a huge plague, or something that kills off a huge amount of the population, it's called a fifth season. And at the beginning of the book, a new fifth season has started. It says in the very beginning of the book, "This is the way the world ends for the last time." I loved the writing. I love the diversity that's included in this book. The magic system is absolutely amazing, and I just had a really good time while reading it. The only thing with this one is that it felt very prequel-ish to me. This is the first book in the series, and it felt more like a book that you would read after you finish the series and then had more questions, you'd go back and read it. But other than that, I absolutely loved it, and I gave it 4.75 stars, like I already said. I also did a book review for this, which will be up in the card symbol if you want to check out more of my thoughts. After I ordered the second book after the fifth season, I was waiting for it to arrive, so I picked up Snapshot by Brandon Sanderson. This one follows a guy who is a detective, and in this world, they can do what's called creating a snapshot, which is a recreation of an entire day, and then detectives can go in and try to track down the murderers and try to find the evidence that they can use in real life to close the cases releases and everything like that. The main character, Anthony Davis, has heard of some rumors of these police reports that have gone missing or have been taken out of the record, and so he wants to investigate some of those things himself, and so he convinces his partner to do that with him. I ended up really enjoying this. I gave it 3.5 stars because I definitely think that there were some things that could have been improved upon, and I thought that the ending was pretty rushed and abrupt, but overall I did have a really good time and I am very happy to have read this and to add this wonderful, amazing edition of it to my shelves, which it is leather bound and signed. And the 60th thing that I read in 2017 is going to be The Gigantic Beard That Was Evil by Stephen Collins. This is a middle grade-ish graphic novel that follows this guy who lives in a perfect town, and it's all very well kept. Everyone is very orderly. Everything is precisely how it's supposed to be. And then in the novel, the main character ends up growing a beard, which is not a good thing and is considered evil. And then everyone is trying to figure out how to stop this beard from growing and how to get rid of this beard. It has messages like not hiding who you are and not being ashamed of the way that you look and everything like that. And also not judging someone for being different, as well as embracing your differences. I thought that it was really well done. I absolutely loved it. I ended up giving it 4 stars. And if you've been looking for some graphic novels, this one is a really fun one. So those are the next 5 things that I read in 2017. Well, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and comment down below what you've been reading recently. Do you have any suggestions for me? Anything else you want me to know, leave it down below, and I will talk to you guys next time.